three gears. Only one hand. No minute hand, very simple times. And this balance at the top acts as the pendulum. To wind it up, we have to pull this two times a day. The farmers used to make these clocks in the winter when they were snowed in, when they couldn't work their lands, and they would sell the clocks at the summer markets to make some extra money. And that's how the clock making industry began in the Black Forest. The next generation of clocks, we have the shield clock. It's also known as the clock with the painted face. For the first time in 1760, they added our friend Mr. Cuckoo. That's why this clock has two weights. One is for the cuckoo, the other one is for the clock. It also has a pendulum and a minute hand. And here we have a man working away. And there's a nice lady standing behind him, holding something in her hand.
Must be a nice wife.
So every 30 minutes, she gets to hit him on the head.
There you go. On the lady's lap.
With a large rolling pin.
There you go.
That's much more time.
She has no hair left. This is a little old lady that arrives in the family when you get married.
Any guesses? Daughter-in-law.
What's that?
Mother-in-law. Yeah.
Mother-in-law.
They're not all like that, of course not. In 1860, they designed this clock here for the railway stations in Germany. It's called the Station House Clock. It has the roof of the railway station and also the tracks of the train as decorations. This clock here has an extra weight. This one has three weights. And that is because it will play music for you. So if you look up here, just under where the cuckoo pops out, you'll notice some people. They will start dancing around to some music. And the people are now dancing around on a mechanism like this one here. Everybody see? So these two here, they have the music, and these ones here are without music. The mechanism is made out of brass. The daily winding cuckoo clocks, they have small weights like this one here, so somebody would have to wind it just one time during the day. The 8-day cuckoo clocks, they have the larger weights, so somebody would have to wind it every 8 days. And the cuckoo sound comes from these little devices here. These act as bellows. The air goes through here and comes out of here like a flute, and there are different sizes for different clocks, all with a slightly different tone. And that's the cuckoo sound. It's very simple, but it works. So no need for batteries. And then we have the music box. We put the music box against the wood, and the wood will resonate the sound like a musical instrument, like a guitar or a violin. And for the hand-carved decorations around the exterior of the clocks, the animals, the trees, the crown at the top, they use this wood here. In the UK, we call it limewood. In the States, you call it basswood. It's also known as lindenwood. And they have to set the wood to dry for 4 years before they can start carving. Otherwise the wood would split. So it's soft wood and it has hardly any grain. That's why it's good for carving. And here we have the cuckoo house. This is the only part that is actually cut by machine. So by simply adding the hand carved decorations, we have a basic cuckoo clock. Mm. If you'd like to follow me over to the other wall.